So in the today's class, before talking our module called SAP MM, let's we start with the introduction to the ERP. What are the ERP packages, ERP products available, the goals and objectives of ERP, the history of SAP, and how this SAP ERP product is providing the solutions to the industries or to the companies. What are technical modules? What are functional modules? Then we'll discuss about the business process and what is this SAP MM module, why we need this module called SAP MM, the purpose and necessity of the module SAP MM, where the business of this SAP MM module will start and where it ends. So first, what is an ERP? So ERP stands for Enterprise Resource Planning. So what is this enterprise means? A well-established company or organization. Now, when we take any organization, we need some sort of the resources to run the organization. Manpower, materials, machinery, money, method, and time. With proper planning of purchase, production, sales, quality, maintenance, etc. Any company using the resources by planning to improve or to develop or to grow rapidly by the utilization of all these resources to run the day-to-day business process is called ERP, Enterprise Resource Planning. Okay, so in the market, there are so many ERP packages or products available. Okay, now for example, whether you have come across the product called Tally, T-A-L-L-Y, Tally. So it is a product, okay, where small scale entrepreneurs or small scale business people can run for accounting purpose. So this Tally product is used for accounting package to run all the day-to-day financial accountings or to run all the financial related transactions. Okay, where it is widely used in the country India. Okay, now in the recent times, down the line 2 years back, it is declared as a one of the ERP product. Now we call it the same name, we call it as a Tally ERP. So it means it is listed under ERP segment, and which is widely used or which is being used 2 years or 3 years back in the country India only. So out of the origin India, nobody know the product called Tally. In the similar manner, there are so many ERP products: Wings, IDMS, Focus, Spark, etc. So like this, there are so many ERP products which are used in different parts of origins and which are not known by the companies or the business people who are running their day-to-day business transaction in India. Okay, so if you take globally, universally, these are the ERP products or packages available in the market. So we cannot say these ERP products are located or they are operated or they are used only in India or they are operated in Australia or New Zealand or in Asian countries, etc. So these are the ERP packages or products are available or used by all the companies and all the business entrepreneurs in different parts of origin. They are not only the ERP packages, they are the organizations, they are the companies: SAP, Oracle, PeopleSoft, JD Edwards, Bond, Microsoft Dynamics, Ramco, etc., etc., etc. They are not only the ERP products, they are the companies, they are the organizations. Okay, and the fourth one, JD Edwards, it is just a ERP product, but it is not a company. JD Edwards is just a ERP product, but it is not a company. So out of which, the SAP is a leader in the ERP environment. In the sense, 80 to 85% of the market has been totally captured by SAP ERP product itself. So we have so many reasons, advantages and limitations, why the SAP is a leader in the ERP environment. Now coming to the ERP package usages in the companies. Now why they are using this ERP products or ERP packages? Okay, so you are going to come across to increase the productivity, reduce the cost of production, increase your system performance and customer satisfaction. That is quick ROI to the company, where ROI stands for return on investment. So these are the advantages and limitations for going to a product called ERP and why the companies are using this ERP product to run their day-to-day business transactions. Now we talk about our product called SAP EAG. It's a registered and trademark. It is not only an ERP product, it is an organization company founded in the year 1972 by former IBM employees. So previously they are working in IBM company and they came out of IBM company and they started this company called SAP EAG. Company located in Waldorf in Germany. So it's purely a German-based ERP product and German-based company. We should never pronounce it as a SAP. It is an abusive word in the German language. So that's the reason we're supposed to call it as a SAP. Stands for Systems, Applications and Products in a Data Processing. So that is an expansion and abbreviation of SAP. And what is this EAG means? Now, just now we discussed these are the ERP packages or products available globally in different parts of origin. So this SAP, they have their own development centers, research and development centers, software services, okay, service providers in different parts of the world, not only in India, America, Australia, New Zealand, UK, etc. Now they do have operations in India. Therefore, we call this company as a SAP India Limited. So that is the naming of the companies in India. The same company located in Australia, New Zealand, USA, UK, etc. We call it a SAP INC, Incorporation or Corporation. Okay. So the companies which are located in Germany, we have AG, stands for AG. It is a German word and German pronunciation. Okay. So the same company located in different parts of origin, the name conversion has been different. So in India, we call it a limited. In USA, UK, we call it incorporation or corporation. And in Germany, they will have AG. Okay. It is a German word and German pronunciation. And these are the five people who are the founders of this company and the ERP product. So Dietmar Hopp, Hans Werner Hector, Klaus Wallenruther, Klaus Schirra, Hasso Plattner are the five Germans who are the founders of this company and the ERP product. Now, how this SAP is providing the solutions to the industries? This SAP ERP product is divided into two segments. What are those? Technical and functional. So called as the technical modules and so called as the functional modules. So people working in the technical department, we call as a technical consultants, and people working in the functional side, we call as a functional consultants. Okay. Now coming to technical modules, the SAP technical modules are suitable for the people who are already working in IT industry, in the software industry on different platforms. So you might be working as a developer, as a programmer. Again, in programming, you have so many flavors, programming languages, different programming languages. And people who are working on third-party softwares, data migrations, and people working as a database administrator, system administrator, network administrators, etc. Kind of people are suitable for technical modules. So for going for technical module, there is some prerequisite. Should have some IT skills, IT knowledges required for technical environment. Okay. Now ABAP, it is a programming language in SAP. It stands for Advanced Business Application Programming. Suppose I am working in an organization in a software company as a programmer, as a developer. Then after 2 to 3 years of experience, I want to migrate into SAP platform. So I have 3 years of experience, then I can go to a module called ABAP. So I want to go as a developer, as a programmer in SAP environment also. Then you'll go to for ABAP. So if you want to learn ABAP, so the basic things that we should know is some programming skills are required. It's a mandatory, I can say, like C, C++, the basic programming languages are required, without which directly you cannot go for learning of an ABAP. Similarly, BASIS, it stands for Business Administration System Integrator Solution. People who are background of experience as a network administrator, system administrator, database administrators, system analyst, networking analyst, kind of people suitable for this module called BASIS. BIBW, Business Information Warehouse or Business Intelligence. So this is used for reporting generation purpose. So as per the client business requirement, this module is suitable for the generating the reports and getting the statistical analysis of the business process and day-to-day transactions going on in the companies. So you should have some knowledge of ABAP also required for this one. XAPA, Exchange Infrastructure and Process Integration. So people who are already working in ABAP or completed training on ABAP can go for this module called XAPA. MDM, Master Data Management. Now this MDM is not there. It was clubbed in another technical module. Again, you have Fiori, User Interface, WebDime Pro, etc. So like this, you have different technical flavors in our SAP ERP environment. Okay. Now coming to the functional modules. What are these functional modules? For example, let us say I will take a company called Asian Paints, or I will take John Deere. Okay. So it's a very multinational company where they manufacture tractors. Okay. So earth movers, etc. Some different types of products they are going to manufacture. John Deere is very famous company. Now today, this organization, the entire John Deere company, their business runs on SAP. So he is the biggest customer to the company SAP. Now let us say in this company, we have so many departments. What are those departments? Accounting department, costing department, purchasing department, warehouse department, sales and marketing department, production department, maintenance, or even we can call it a engineering department, projects department, quality control, or in some company they call it a quality assurance department, personnel and administration department, safety department, customer service department, etc., etc., etc. So in this organization, we have so many departments. Okay. So in a company, these are all departments, and which each and every department is integrated. I'll tell you what is this integration later on. Okay. So accounting, costing, purchasing, warehouse, sales, production, maintenance, projects, quality, administration, safety, customer service, or the departments, or the business where the business activities, day-to-day business transactions are controlled or looked after by all these departments in that company called John Deere. Okay. Now, all these departments of this organization. Now, let us say we are implementing SAP to this company called John Deere. Okay, let us say we are implementing, we got the project, we are implementing SAP to this client, who is a client, John Deere company. Okay, now they said that these are the departments in our organization. Okay, so these are all the day-to-day business activities which will go on in our company, and these are the products what we manufacture, and these are the materials, these are the customers, etc. Okay. So these are the companies we came to know, which are operated by this organization or client. So when we compare with our SAP ERP product, these are treated as the functional modules in our SAP. Each and every department is treated as a functional module. Now, accounting or financial, we call as a FI. FI stands for financial accounting. Okay, the module name is FI, financial accounting. And the person who is working as a FI on working on this module called FI, we call them as a FI consultant. Costing or controlling, we call as a CO, controlling consultant, and the model is called controlling. Previously, FI CO is a common module, guys. We supposed to call as a FICO, financial accounting and controlling. Now, in the recent times, SAP is cut it into two pieces. Now, we call as a SAP FI is different, SAP CO is different. But if you, the people who are going for planning for controlling, or if you want to work on controlling CO, compulsory FI is mandatory. Without knowledge of FI, the people cannot go for CO. Purchasing, that is materials management, warehouse management, sales and marketing comes under sales and distribution, production planning comes under production planning and control. Engineering department or maintenance department comes to a module called plant maintenance. Projects department comes under a module called PS. Quality assurance or quality control department comes under quality management. Personal administration department comes under human resources. Safety department comes under the module called environmental health and safety. And customer service department we call as a customer service, which are treated as the functional modules in our SAP ERP product. So that the reason to learn these functional modules, there is no any prerequisite. It means any knowledge of IT skills or IT knowledge or programming skills. No, not at all. I have decided to learn SAP MM. So do I need any programming skills or IT skills, IT knowledge? No, not at all. Okay. So these are the functional modules in SAP, and which are treated as a departments in any organization. And these functional modules are treated as a the base functional modules in our SAP ERP product. The base functional module means which are mandatory functional modules for any organization. Okay. Apart from that, we have next advanced functional modules in our SAP ERP product. These advanced functional modules are suitable for the people who are previously working on the base functional modules. Now, for example, SRM is there, supplier relationship management. Recently, the name has changed to Ariba, ARIBA, Ariba. This module is suitable for the people who are already completed training on MM module or working on MM module, can go to the module called SRM. Next, advanced. So MM is mandatory. In a similar manner, CRM stands for customer relationship management, background of SD, sales and distribution. APO, advanced planner and optimizer, background of production planning module. EWM, extended warehouse management, mainly people background of MM and WM can go for this one. BPC, business process and consolidation, background of FICO. And apart from that, the SAP is separately providing the solutions to different industry segments. We call it the IS, retail industries, oil and gas industries, utilities. Utilities means the industries which comes under electrical, electronics, powers, cables, all these comes under utility sectors. Healthcare, automotive, pharmaceutical, media, banking, railways, etc. Now coming to the architecture of SAP, the system architecture, we call it SAP R/3, R/1, R/2. First of all, what is meaning of R? Real-time data processing. And 1, 2, 3 are system architecture. So single tier is nothing but a standalone system. Example, our personal computer, which is used for personal purpose. two-tier architecture. Our IBM mainframe system is called two-tier architecture. It is divided into two layers. Presentation and application is one layer, database layer is another layer. Now, what our SAP follows is SAP R/3. It is divided into three-tier architecture. The presentation layer is GUI, graphical user interface, application layer, web application, and database layer is Oracle, DB2, Sybase, etc. So this is a system architecture. Now coming to versions in SAP, that is the software versions which are used in our SAP ERP product. In the olden day, they started with version 3.0. Then later on, they upgraded to different versions, 4.0, 4.5, 6, 7, ECC 5.0, ECC 6.0, now ECC 6.0, EHP 5 or EHP 6, 7, 8, etc. From version to version, the hardware-wise, the software-wise, the business applications-wise, the data security-wise has been tremendously increased. And moreover, these advanced functional modules are suitable only when the base version of SAP should be on the latest version, ECC 6.0, EHP 5, R6, R7, R8. For example, a company, a client who is using the version, the oldest version, let us say, for example, the company is using 4.5 version. Let us say, for example, actually 4.5, 6, 7 versions are already outdated. They are not, SAP is providing the solutions for the companies, only for limited companies, people who are using. Now 4.7, so the Sony company located in Japan. So for that company, still the SAP is providing the services on the version 4.7. And even in India, Reliance Industries, Mukesh Ambani group of industries also, in some areas, still they are using 4.7 something else. For only for certain clients or companies, still SAP is supporting it. Okay. So if these companies want to go for advanced functional model, let us say, these versions will not suitable. 4.5, 6, 7 will not suitable. So first, the client or customer should migrate to the latest version before going to the advanced functional modules. So like this, some changes, updations, okay, and new facilities regarding the business prospective point of view, data security point of view, regarding the hardware and software, keeping all these factors into consideration, the SAP has keep on updating to their product into different versions. And in our training program, and even in the real time also, we are going to use the latest versions, guys. Where ECC stands for Enterprise Central Component and EHP stands for Enhanced Package. So this is the SAP installations by industries. So insurance, media, it means the industry segments, okay? So SAP is providing the solutions to almost all industry segments, pharma, chemical, retail, consumer products, engineering, construction, aerospace, oil and gas, telecommunications, utilities, public sector companies, etc., etc., etc. Now I told you SAP is a ERP product, or we call it a ERP package. We cannot call it as a programming. Okay. SAP is called a ERP product or ERP package. So these are all the departments, or these are all the functional modules which are integrated to one another. What is the word called integrated? I will tell you now. So coming to functional modules. So logistics. What is the meaning of logistics? Okay. Logistics will comprises all the departments, in the sense, right from identifying of the need of the raw material in an organization until delivering the finished metal to the customer. So all these business activities totally comes under logistics. We call it a supply chain management. That is purchase, inventory, warehouse, quality, production, again quality, sales, delivery the finished metal to the customer. So this and all comes under logistics. MM stands for materials management. This module totally deals or talks about the procurement activities or purchasing activities, how it takes place in any organization. Identify the need of the material, interaction with the supplier, creation of the order, receiving the stock of the material from the supplier, checking the quality, and releasing the payment to the supplier. All these business activities will come to a module called MM, Materials Management. PP stands for Production Planning and Control. The main agenda of this module, the main aim of this module is generation of the or production of the finished material, producing the end component as per the customer business requirement. So in production planning module, we have different types of plannings, means make to order planning, make to stock planning. What is meaning of make to order? You have the meaning in the statement itself. Whenever customer place an order to the company, then only the company will start the planning and they will execute it and finally deliver the finished material to the customer. Example, companies like compressors, pumps, motors, diesel generators. Okay, so these are all, now for example, you take pump manufacturing company. Each and every customer requires or needs a material called pump. That is a finished component. But this product pump is used in different industry segments. Okay, now for example, so what is this make to order? So this business understanding this process is important. So production planning, the production of the finished material depends upon two types of planning, guys. One is we call as a MTO, another we call as a MTS. MTO means make to order, MTS means make to stock. MTO means it's a make to order planning. Whenever customer places an order to the company, then only the company will start the production planning activities. So there is an impact of the customer business requirement. There is an impact of the sales order. Okay. So because now pump. Okay. So here the base, the finished component or end component is pump. Now one customer requires pump. So again in pump, you have different types of varieties. I can say centrifugal pump, reciprocating pump, turbine pump. So this is one type. So one customer maybe requires with this specification, another customer requires with this specification, another customer requires with this specification. But final component will be pump only. Okay. Next, another customer requires of horsepower 200 HP. Another customer, maybe his requirement is 100 HP. Another customer required 50 HP. Discharge pressure. One customer requires 100 PSI. Another customer requires the same product of the requirement, etc. Maximum discharge pressure and maximum discharge flow, 200 liters. Etc. So here every customer requires the product is pump, but their specifications have been changing. One customer requires centrifugal, one customer requires horsepower of this much, with the pressure of this much, with the discharge flow of this much. And pump is used in so many industries, right? Now market segment, so some customers they need for domestic, some customers they need for industry, and some customers they need for agriculture, because this product is used everywhere, right? It will be used in our home, it will be used in industries, it will be used in agriculture. So every customer requires the same product, but their requirements has been changed, the specifications have been changed. So this business requirement, when our company will get it, we call as a make to order planning. As per the customer requirement, they need to plan the requirement. They need to produce a finished material. Make to stock planning means customer, company will not wait for customer order. I will not wait for customer order. I will execute it. I will do the production. I'll make the finished materials available stocks in my inventory. Whenever customer places an order, immediately deliver the materials. Example, all your supermarket items, all your grocery items, okay, all your food related products. For that, we'll not wait for customer requirement, isn't it? I will do the production in bulk. I'll make the stocks available in my inventory, in my stores. Whenever customer places an order, immediately deliver the material to the customer. That is called make to stock planning. So like this, keeping the customer requirement into consideration, production planning people will produce a finished material. Then later on, interaction with the customers, on-time delivery of the material, picking, packing, shipping, loading and unloading the materials, receiving the payments from the customer, all these activities will come to a department called sales and marketing department, and the module is called sales and distribution. QM stands for quality management. So obviously, when you take any organization, each and every material, whether it is a purchasable material or a producible material, so each and every materials and goods which are produced or which are procured or purchased, we need to check the quality of the material. Unless and until we don't check the quality of the materials and goods, neither you can place the stock of the materials in the warehouse, in the stores, nor you can receive the or remove the stocks of the materials and deliver to the customer. Okay, each and every product should be check the quality. So all the quality related activities will come to a department called quality control department or quality assurance department. That module we call as a quality management. PM stands for plant maintenance. So when you take a organization or a company, we are going to use different types of machineries, isn't it? Compressors, boilers, heat exchangers, pumps, motors, AC motors, DC motors, diesel generators, etc. So what happens, guys, when you keep on running up these machineries 24/7, 365 days, at regular intervals of time, we are supposed to perform services and maintenance activities, isn't it? What is the reason behind? Because in order to run all these machines smoothly, okay, there should not be any disturbance when the production process is going on. If you don't perform these services regularly, if you don't monitor the maintenance activities of all these machineries and equipments regularly, so what happens? It is a loss for the production planning department. It is a loss to the company. What is the reason? Because in each and every day, the production process is not going properly. It means company target is they need to produce 200 tons of the end product per day, but they could not unable to reach the target. Hardly they are reaching 110 tons or 120 tons. What is the remaining difference of 80 tons? They are unable to. Why? What is the reason? Because the machineries or equipments are not running in a proper way. In each and every day, they are getting breakdown maintenance or because of any other failure or because of cost for the damage, cost for the... There are so many reasons behind that. So in order to avoid all these disturbances and all, the plant maintenance, that is the maintenance department, the engineering department, okay, in order to avoid all these failures, damages, etc., they need to perform regular and services activities for the machineries and equipments. That comes to a module called plant maintenance. Financial accounting and controlling. This module is totally related to the accounting and expenses related kind of things looked after by this module. Accounts payable, payable to the suppliers, accounts receivables, receive the payments from the customers. All these activities will come to a department called accounting or financial or controlling department, and the module is called FICO, financial accounting and controlling. And service management, customer services. So whenever company deliver their finished products and all, so issuing the complaints or is there any issues are there related to the customers, the department will relate to customer service department. In the similar manner, human resources, it is related to your HR, looking after all the personal and administration related activities. And apart from that, there will be safety department also. What is the meaning of safety? Okay, in each and every organization, whenever we are doing this production process or any, if you take a plant, a manufacturing company, a factory or a site, So employees are going to perform so many different types of operations. Okay, so group of people working in some area, group of people working in some area, and group of people performing some other task, some other activity, etc. So if you take industries like pharma, chemical, drugs, okay, food industries, cosmetics, healthcare, in this type of industry segments, the safety plays major role. What is the reason? Because the employees who are working in these organizations, they are going to deal with hazardous and perishable materials where it may cause their life in danger. Okay. Therefore, in these organizations, there will be one department called safety department, and the person we call is a safety engineer. So what is his roles? What is the responsibility of the safety engineer? He has to provide a set of guidelines, a set of instructions for the people who are working or who are performing the different tasks in the manufacturing unit. Okay. So a person who is working as a safety engineer in any manufacturing company, he is a person suitable for learning a functional module called environmental health and safety. Okay. So like this, we have different functional modules in our SAP ERP product. Now coming to technical side, as I said, ABAP is a programming language. So people who are interested to go as a developer, as a programmer, can go to a module called ABAP. It stands for Advanced Business Application Programming. It is a programming language in our SAP ERP product. Now coming to the basis, it stands for Business Administration System Integrator Solution. People who are working as a network administrator, system administrator, data administrator can go to this module called basis. So like this, the SAP is providing the solutions into technical and functional. Now we talk about the business process. This is very, very important. You take any organization, the process remains the same. It's a basic funda. What is this procurement types means? In the market, you take any organization, a company, the procurement types are classified into two categories. What are those? They are external procurement and internal procurement. Let us say a customer called Alex or a company, they need a finished material. What is the finished material? D is a finished material. And the requirement of the customer is 1 lakh tons of the material per month. So it's a very good business requirement. 1 lakh tons per month means, see how much requirement of the customers and how much volume of the business is getting to the company. The result of this material D is a result of the raw materials ABC. So mix of the raw materials ABC or finished, subcomponents, result will be D material. Therefore, this customer will approach to a company XYZ. So here, so customer requirement is finish, or even we can call it a end component, that is material D. And requirement per month, let us say 100,000 tons of the material. It's a huge requirement. This material D, the finished material D, is a result of either you call it as a raw materials or you call it as a subcomponents. Materials A, B, C. Okay. So customer has placed an order to the company, XYZ company, private limited. So customer and company, the relation between these two will be the sales order. So here, the important point I want to inform you guys is, whatever may be the software applications or the tools the companies are using, it may change us. The screens, the options, or the name of the product will change us. but the business process remain the same. Okay, so customer and company, what could be the relation between these two? Sales order. So in our SAP ERP product, we call it as a sales order. In another non-SAP ERP product also, we call it as a sales order. It's a generic word. Or leave about all the softwares. Generally, you take normally as per the industry standard, or also we call it as a sales order only. So it is a legal document which is created and maintained between the customer and company. When the company accepts the requirement, we call it as a demand management and independent requirement planning. So company has accept the customer requirement. Okay, Alex, our company is ready to supply the finished material D for your organization. Now, company has to check the availability of the resources, isn't it? Because company has accept the customer requirement. They have the customer business requirement in their hands. So availability check. So system has to check the availability of the resources. It may be material, manpower, equipment, machinery, all the resources they need it because they got a huge customer business requirement. Then the word comes MRP. In this, normally MRP we call as a maximum retail price. Yes, even MRP is also called as maximum retail price. But in this context, we call it as a material requirement planning. Very, very important. MRP stands for material requirement planning. So it basically it is a planning tool. So any company cannot blindly produce a finished material, or they cannot blindly purchase a raw material, isn't it? Unless and until when they identify the need of that material. So they have identified the requirement, requirement identification. So I cannot go blindly into the market and I cannot select the suppliers, I cannot purchase raw material. In a similar manner, production department cannot produce the finished material blindly unless and until when we are in need of it. That requirement will comes from the source is MRP. The MRP will decide what type of requirement it is. The first case is no stock available. What is meaning of no stock available? So the customer has came to the company, he has given the business requirement, and the company has accept the customer requirement. Okay, now Shekhar has accept the customer requirement. Okay, Alex, our company is ready to supply the material, whatever the finished material your company needs. Okay, on the other hand, the company don't have the stocks of the raw materials. That is called no stock available. I have the order, customer order in my hands, and at the same time the raw material stock is zero, no stock available. Then what the company will do then? The company will go for planning, and the order is called planned order. And the document we call is a planned order. As a company don't have the inner stocks of the raw materials, company has to go for purchase. So we call it a purchase requisition. In shortcut, we call it a PR. Okay, Shekhar has identified the need of the materials, that is raw materials A, B, and C. So from where I am going to get this materials? I have identified my requirement of the material, that is raw materials ABC. So where I will go and where I will can where I can get that raw materials? So I need to find out the source of supply, that is source determination, nothing but vendors. So in the market, I came to know the supplies available. I have vendor 1, vendor 2, vendor 3, vendor 4, vendor 5, vendor 6, vendor 7, etc. So I found some suppliers who can supply the excellent quality of the materials ABC. Now here the buyer is a Shekhar. Now I will approach to the suppliers. How I am going to approach to the suppliers? Will I send a WhatsApp message to the suppliers, or will we send an email, or will send a any printout and send them information through fax or something else? No, I am going to approach to the suppliers in the form of quotation, so-called RFQ, request for quotation. So Shekhar is requests the raw material. Their company is in need of raw materials. So I need to approach to the suppliers. How I am going to approach suppliers? In the form of quotation, request for quotation. We call this as the tenders also. And vendors is called bidders. So I'll send the quotations to different suppliers. to vendor 1, vendor 2, vendor 3, vendor 4, etc. I don't know whether they supply the material or not, but it's my responsibility. I need to approach to the suppliers. So I'll send the quotations to all the suppliers. They will receive. If they are ready to supply the material, so they will get back with their information. So, okay, Shekhar, our company is ready to supply the material to your company, provided these are my terms and conditions, my warranty, my services, my reliability, blah, 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 blah. Now, vendor two says, okay, Shekhar, I am ready to supply the material to your organization, provided these are my terms and conditions, warranty, services, reliability, blah, 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 blah. So like this, I will receive all the quotations from all the suppliers. Then I'll do price comparison for the quotations and I'll select the supplier on the basis of price, quality, delivery, and the service. Now, as a buyer, I know the materials what I want to buy, raw materials ABC. Now, I know the source, the supplier from where I can buy. Okay. A relationship between the buyer and the supplier, so called PO, purchase order. What is a purchase order? It is a legal document which is created and maintained between the buyer and the supplier. Once purchase order is created, the purchase order will go for approval, which will be approved by your manager or vice president, senior vice president, senior manager, manager, deputy manager, etc. That depends upon the organization hierarchy. Once purchase order is approved, it will be sent to the vendor. That you may send depending upon their mode of communication. Some companies may send through fax or through courier or through email, whatever may be the communication between the two ends. Then purchase order confirmation, will get the acknowledgement. Again, as a purchase order, vendor will send the material. So we create a GR with reference to purchase order, stands for goods receipt. So obviously, once you receive the material, a sample of the material will be sent to the quality department and they will do whatever the quality test they want to do it. And finally, they will declare the results, whether we need to accept the stock or reject the stock. So once you accept the stock, place in your stores, in your warehouse, then vendor will send the invoice, company will receive the invoice, they will check the invoice, they will verify and finally release the invoice for the payment. So payment to the vendor, done by the financial department. So right from identifying of the need of the material up to payment to the supplier, this total procurement comes under procurement called external procurement. That is the result of our model called SAP MM. So why we need the model called SAP MM? The purpose of SAP MM model, where it starts and where it ends. The other name for MM is purchase to pay or else order to pay. So external procurement leads to a model called SAP MM, guys. Okay. So when this process takes place, guys, when the company don't have the enough stock of the any raw material, for example, if you have the stocks of raw materials ABC, if you have deficit of stock of material C, so compulsory you need to purchase it. You need to have the equal stocks of the raw materials so as to produce a customer finished material. Got the point? The other case is stock available. What is meaning of stock available? The customer has placed an order to the company to execute it. Now the company is having the stocks of the raw materials. That is called stock available. So what happens here? So planning will take place and the order is called planned order. Okay, as the company is having the stocks of the raw materials, so there is no word called purchase, isn't it? Because we have the stocks. We have stocks more than the customer's specific requirements, and we have safety stock, and even we have buffer stock. If emergency, another customer requirement comes also, we are ready to do the production. So we have enough stocks of the raw materials. Then create a production order. Release the production order for the production process. Goods issue. So we need to supply the raw materials, isn't it? So supply the raw materials from store to production department. Confirm the production order. So total production process will be done. And GR, again, is a production order. So finished material is produced. Again, here also sample of the material will be sent to the quality department. They will check the sample, they will give the result. After that, we'll place the stock in the stores or in the warehouse. Then technically complete the production order. Still, if the production process pending is there, we'll technically complete and production settlement. They'll compare all the target and actual cost of the production. Finally, deliver material to the customer. Where sales billing and sales invoice takes place, receive the payments from the customer, done by the financial department. So here company is going to receive the payments from whom? From customer. That will be done by financial department. In the previous case, company is doing the payments for whom? To the vendor, from where we are purchase the raw material. So this total procurement comes under a procurement called internal procurement, that leads to a module called PP. So finally, this is the entire flow diagram, guys. If you understand this business process, it is as simple as that. The modules are MM, whatever the any other modules. Okay. So first customer places an order to the company, it triggers MRP. So once MRP is triggered, the MRP decides what type of planning you to go. If the company don't have the enough stocks of raw materials, so what happens, guys? External procurement takes place. There is procurement of the raw material, that is purchasing of the raw materials. The word external means from outside we are going to purchase the material. The accounts payable, so paying the payment, doing the payment to the suppliers. When we have the stocks of the raw materials, no need to go for purchase. So therefore production planning will take place. You start the production as per the customer requirement, execute the finished material. So here financial will not come here. Costing will come. Controlling will department or costing department will estimate the cost of the finished materials. Then finally, already we have the customer order. So ship the material, sales invoice, and receive the payments from the customer. See here, each and every department is integrated to one another. There is nothing but the functional modules. So as I told you, it is a SAP is a ERP product or ERP package. So each and every functional modules are integrated to one another. So this is the integration. So it starts with sales, one end it will goes to purchase, end with finance, other end it will go for production, end with the costing, then again it will go to the sales, ends with the finance. And in the middle, you'll have the warehouse, again you'll have the quality. All these will be there, guys. Suppose here, where the quality will come? So goods is shipped. What happens in at this stage? Raw materials quality will be checked and it will be placed in the stores. Again, from stores, what we'll do? We'll issue the material to whom? To the production department. So from MM, when the stocks are moving to the production, quality will take place. So here also, once you produce a finished material, once you place the stock of the finished material in the stores, you are going to ship the material. Again, from production to sales, again, quality will check. So QM also will be there here. Okay. Nice. So this is very, very important, guys. Okay. So procurement types, you take any organization, external procurement, internal procurement. Okay. Whatever may be the nature of the company. So customer has placed an order to the company and company has accepted the customer requirement. Then what happens? How the company is going to react and how the company is going to execute the things and how the company is going to deliver the finished material as per the customer requirement. So this is the basic fundamental flow diagram. So this is our procurement cycle or MM cycle. Okay. Requirement identification, source determination, vendor selection, PO processing, PO monitoring, goods received, invoice verification, and payment process, payment to the vendor. So we call this as a procurement cycle or MM cycle. Purchase to pay or order to pay. So to perform all these activities in our SAP ERP product, we need to design or we need to frame the SAP organization structure. So without designing this organization structure, we cannot run the show in SAP. And this is a course content what we are going to discuss in our training program. Organization structure, master data. So here the introduction will be, we have seen it, ERP packages, introduction to SAP, function objectives of MM, logistic cycles, MM flow and procurement types, then organization structure, master data, purchasing, document types, that is configurations of the purchasings, purchase order approvals, pricing procedure, services, automatic PO creations, inventory management, physical inventories, special stocks and special procurement types. We have some business concepts like consignment, stock transfer, subcontracting, pipeline handling process, returnable, third party processing, batch management, material valuations and split valuation, invoice verification. Apart from that, we are going to see how our module MM is integrated with other modules like financial accounting and controlling, sales and distribution, production planning, warehouse management, and integration with quality management. So this is our course content, what we are going to discuss in our training program.